This is something to celebrate.
I believe so.
This is a great drink. Tequila Gran Diamante is one of the newest brands in the spirit market. I'm Michael Real, and this is Real Urban News. To learn more about this premium tequila, ultra premium tequila, we speak with one of the co-founders, Charles Harris. We're at a simple bar. This is Real Urban News. Charlie Harris, this name, Tequila Gran Diamante. What a powerful but yet interesting name for your tequila brand.
Diamante, the diamond, is it's a strong name in Mexico, so it was only right for us to name it that. Look, if you see the bottle, it just fit perfect. So we went with it.
Tequila market is flooded.
Definitely.
There are a lot of different brands out, a lot of distinct taste. What separates Gran Diamante from the crowded fare?
Tequila Gran Diamante is what's called an ultra premium tequila. So in that area or that that satchel where there's not many competitors. So you can put us up against 1942, Class Azul, Cigoros, those brands. So and I believe with what we created, I'd put us on top of those, on the top, based off of the presentation, the packaging,
sure.
And the juice that's in the bottle. We go neck and neck with those guys.
Are you surprised that this brand, this tequila, is doing as well as it is? It's an ultra, as you say, premium tequila.
Am I surprised? No, because we put in the hard work to get it to this point. Both the bottle, and what's inside of it is perfection. It's like a diamond.
And so this is not just your standard, we have some tequila, let's put it in a bottle, let's slap a label on it. No. You all have done the homework, the research, and this is now a premium brand.
It's a premium brand, yeah. We put in the hard work from the bottle, like I said, the bottle design, getting that by itself was an upward climb. And then just the juice inside of it, we went into the lab and over and over and over again until we got that perfect taste that we were looking for.
And what were you all looking for in terms of taste and smoothness? And
we wanted a more traditional taste. A lot of, depending on who you talk to, some people like the sweeter tequilas, and we wanted to go more traditional taste to it. Not as sweet, a little sweet, but smooth.
Talk about the distilling process.
Our distiller is in Arandas, Jalisco. Jalisco obviously is a state in Mexico. Arandas is the town that the distillery is in. And if a lot of people don't know, if you look on the back of any bottle, there's what's called a NOM number.
Sure.
This is an identification of what distillery it came from. So ours is 1460. To getting that certification to call it tequila, like, so it has to be in, the agave has to be grown in that region, in Jalisco, to actually put the name tequila on the bottle. And that process, going through that process, there's different governing bodies in Mexico that you have to submit paperwork to get that approved. Anywhere from all this on the back of the bottle has to be approved. Before you can even hit the market.
This wasn't an overnight success. This has been a journey.
It's been a long journey. 2016 to now, to get to this point, a lot of ups and downs. It was the learning curve was crazy. But we failed, and where most people would pack up and go home, we just kept going. We kept powering through.
What were some of the early challenges that you all were able to power through and overcome before
the bottle
creating what we
the bottle? We had so many companies that said that, oh, we can make the bottle, and they would get we would get the samples, and it looked nothing like our design, what we wanted. So it just took a while to get that. And my partner Rafi, he's a perfectionist. So if it doesn't look right, he's gonna keep going back into the lab and do it over and over and over until we get it right. So that was the biggest obstacle, is definitely the bottle, getting the bottle designed, making it perfect. Because you look at it, it's a custom bottle. We have a US and international patent on that design, and you can see it.
You know what's also interesting about the whole liquor market is the attachment of celebrity. Your brand, this brand, Tequila Gran Diamante, has no celebrity face up front. Is that by design?
It's definitely by design. We wanted to make sure that the brand is able to stand on its own. There's a lot of celebrity brands out there, and the way I looked at it, or the way we looked at it, was what happens if that celebrity loses its
celebrity.
Yeah, it's celebrity, whatever. And what happens to the brand? So we decided to allow our face from the brand is going to be the consumer. Right now, it's a tequila craze. Tequila is the number one spirit in the market right now, by far. And we wanted to create a brand that was going to last past that craze. So what you see, that's what you see. It's a brand that's going to pass. It's not a fly by night brand. It's going to be there in 10 years. It's going to be there in 20 years.
So in 2016, did you all envision tequila being at the top of the spirits market in terms of consumption by consumers?
Definitely, because I come from the hospitality industry, so I seen it firsthand when Patron was taking over, when Don Julio was becoming. I seen Patron go up and as the leader of tequila. And then I seen Don Julio come in and take over from that point. Then I seen Casamigos come in and do their thing. So I seen it. We seen it coming. But instead of running out of the gate to catch up with these guys, we wanted to take our time and get it right. So I think it's our turn.
What's been the response?
The response is big. People love it. My goal was to make sure that our brand was seen. So in the beginning, I was going out myself. And when I was talking to these liquor stores, I would tell them, after they agreed to bring on the brand, I'd tell them I need it either next to or in between 1942 Clase Azul. I want people, when they see those brands, they're gonna see us too.
Tequila Gran Diamante, we have three different flavors behind us. Just give us like a little tequila 101.
The first one here is going to be in the silver bottle. It's our plata. That is distilled, and it's distilled, and then we rested in a stainless steel barrel for about 23 days, and then we bottled it. Then from that point, we have what's called, it's our reposado right here. A reposado in Spanish means resting.
Rest.
And we rest our reposado in a French oak barrel for about 8 months, or minimum of 8 months, I'm sorry, which makes it a traditional reposado. When I say traditional is because a lot of other brands you'll see, because of they want to mass produce, they sometimes do a 3 months or 6 month reposado. But we wanted to go with the traditional route, so it's a minimum of about 8 months.
And that's the standard.
That's the standard. Anything from 3 to about a year. Anything over a year is going to be what's called an añejo.
Okay.
So añejo in Spanish is like aged. So we age our añejo for 18 months in a virgin French oak barrel. So never be used before French oak barrel. Yeah. And this is a fact that a lot of people don't know, is we actually take the barrels from our añejo, we actually rest our reposado in there for 8 months.
Where can we find this?
Liquor stores in Sacramento, Sacramento, LA County, San Diego County, even some in Kern County. You can go to Javier's,
right now, this is a West Coast brand.
It's a West Coast brand for sure. And we're looking to open up into Nevada, Texas, and Arizona markets real soon.
Your background, your nickname is Charlie Bottles. Yep. And we think about that, we think about bottle service. So this is really a natural fit for you.
I guess you could say that. You could say that. I got that name years ago, in my heydays, my party days. I used to party a lot. So the name came about because I was always partying in bottle service. So they would call me Charlie Bottle Service, and then it got short to Charlie Bottles. And now since the people just call me Bottles.
Bottles. But this is no longer partying. This is business.
This is all business.
Tequila Gran Diamante. It's that name. Business. Sounds like business to me.
It's all business.
And how competitive is this tequila market? How competitive?
It's real competitive. We have a lot of, like, it seems like every week another brand is coming out, celebrity brand is coming out. So we're always fighting to make sure we stay relevant in the industry. And people know our name and they're trying and tasting it and push their brand forward.
You all don't have celebrities out front, but you do have a significant celebrity working with you in terms of developing the brand.
I'm talking about James yeah. Harden. Yeah, definitely. James came to us as a fan. He tried the brand, he loved it, and he was like, I love what you guys are doing, and let me be a part of it. So he came in, and that's since then we've been moving forward with that.
Did it make you feel that you all were onto something, on the right track? When you have someone like a James Harden saying, hey, I want this. I like this, I enjoy this.
You have a superstar celebrity, something you created and you put your hard work into, and a superstar celebrity actually loves the brand and willing to put his own money behind it. Of course, it gives you kind of a high where it's like, I created this, I did this. So, oh yeah, for sure.
Are you surprised that you've been able to develop this brand of tequila, have the partnerships that you have this product out in the market on the West Coast, have attached household names from the arena of sports and entertainment? Are you surprised that you yourself are doing so well at this time in your life?
Am I surprised? No. I knew I was coming back to LA and I wanted to do something other than just the main go get a job and have a family and take care of my family. I wanted something a little bit more. And when I left Sacramento to come back to LA to stay, I knew I was gonna do something. Didn't know what it was at that time, but I knew I was coming here to do something great. So am I surprised? No. It's this, I feel like I was made for this. This is what I was, my destiny, this is what I was here to do.
All right, we'll check out the taste and check out the flavor of the Tequila Gran Diamante.
Sounds good.
Hey, bartender.
Ricardo's gonna walk us through some samples here.
Yeah, definitely.
Mix us up. Mix master. Mixologist. Mixologist. Yeah. Now, when we think about tequila, we really don't think of it being mixed. We normally think of just a quick shot, boom, and we're out. But because this is such a grand flavor and flair, this is able to be mixed. What's Ricardo doing for
us? Right now he's letting you taste it. You're gonna have a little tasting, but tequila is made to be sipped. So this is definitely a sipping tequila. So you wanna kind of just enjoy it, sit back and enjoy it like a scotch. You enjoy a scotch. Okay. So he poured a little bit of sample over for you. If you wanna go ahead and try it, see what
I
you
just sip it.
You
I don't,
just
I don't,
sip it. Yeah,
you don't take it back.
Nah. That thing that came back, that comes from the college days. Mm-hmm. Kids going out there drinking well tequila and taking shots and
You want to hear that.
Yeah.
But this is not that.
Nah, this is not that.
This is a high-end or premium tequila.
Ultra premium.
And it's designed for sipping.
For sipping.
And not slurping.
And not slurping. Not shooting. He's making now for
this
us.
It's like an old-fashioned. It's a little twist from the old-fashioned. When I'm making, I did a Café de Olla Simple Syrup. Café de Olla Simple Syrup is a Mexican coffee.
Okay.
So I'll give you a little taste of these two. Just finish that one.
Okay.
It's basically Café de Olla or coffee simple syrup with a chocolate mole bitters.
Okay.
Made it with extra añejo.
And this is prime for mixing tequila. We don't, again, we don't think about tequila being mixed.
As a classic cocktail.
This is a classic cocktail.
Yeah.
I've never thought about tequila like that.
Oh yeah. He makes a really good what are those things called? The vodka, you usually make vodka.
A dirty
martini.
Uh-huh.
With the Tequila Diamante. Uh-huh. The Plata, I believe.
Wow.
In the old fashioned, like you said, uh-huh. he makes a lot of the times when you make a mixed cocktail, you're gonna use maybe the Plata or Reposado. Okay. But with this one he just made now, we're able to use the añejo for the old fashioned.
Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's good.
That's delicious. How do you order this at a bar, at a restaurant, Ricardo? How do I go to my local bar, my local hangout, and I say, hey, I want what? This is a classic cocktail, but how do I describe it to the bartender?
Here at Simple Bar, we have the three expressions of tequila: Gran Diamante, Blanco, Reposado, or Añejo. Some people come to the bar and say, hey, can you surprise me? Make something like different, unique, which is
cocktail. This is different and unique.
Yeah. Why? That's a classic cocktail with a twist, adding Añejo tequila and the ingredients that you're trying, like coffee, simple syrup, and chocolate molde bitters again.
Right, sure.
So also we can make classic margaritas with Tequila Gran Diamante, Blanco, Reposado. We can do Manhattan with Añejo too, or Reposado. So yeah.
When Charlie brought this in, what was your initial thought and response to the brand?
I tried the Blanco first, and it was so smooth, like really smooth. Actually, that's there is slogan, like rethink smooth.
Rethink smooth. Uh-huh. Rethink smooth.
I tried and it was okay. I like it. Uh-huh. I like it. I'll bring it to the bar. And Rafi, that was doing some events, he knows me like making drinks, and he was like, hey, can you do some specialty cocktail with this brand? And I was like, yeah.
Sure.
Yes, if I don't like the brand, I will say no.
Uh-huh.
Get out of here. So yeah, uh-huh. First thing, it was the smooth flavor.
Mm-hmm.
I'm from Jalisco, from Guadalajara, Jalisco. So I've been drinking tequila since I was 10 years old.
You know a thing about tequila. Okay, it was like, in your baby bottle.
Yeah, like this is the thing. And then, before like getting like it is right now.
Sure.
I was like, okay, these guys are gonna make big things in the future.
What's your hope for this brand, Tequila Gran Diamante, going forward?
To be the leader in the industry, to dethrone 1942, Clase Azul, Sigoro. My biggest thing was if life is associating yourself with the elite and then dominate them.
In this spirits game, if you will, in the spirits market, and you alluded to it, or talked about it earlier.
Yeah.
The placement.
Yeah. Placement is
going of your brand among other brands is significant.
Right.
Tell us why.
Because you want, like I said earlier, you want to associate yourself with the elite. So when they come into the store and they're looking for 1942, Clase Azul, Cinco Oro, you want them to see your bottle next to them. So they're going to associate that with being the elite. So what I did is, or what we did is, we went and made sure that in every store you go to, whether it be a restaurant or a liquor store or a nightclub, that placement would be in between or near those elite bottles or elite brands.
What was it for you the first time you saw this brand in the stores, on the shelves, at a bar, or high-end restaurant? This is high-end. This is premium.
It's a surreal feeling. It's especially all the hard work we put into it to finally see your brand on the shelf. It feels real from that point. There was times where in the beginning, I was like, I can't wait to see our bottle on the shelf. And when I seen it, I took pictures, posted on social media.
You were excited about
I was excited about it.
Uh-huh.
And it's a funny feeling.
Finally, what do you want the consumer, people like me who enjoy a premium drink,
yep,
what do you want us to walk away with?
We want the world to enjoy tequila the way tequila was meant to be enjoyed. And when I say that, I mean, obviously, like I said earlier, sipping. It's a sipping tequila. You're supposed to enjoy your drink. You're not supposed to take shots and chase it with a lime and salt. If you want to party, you want to get weird, that's what you do. But when you want to enjoy yourself, you come home from a long day of work, you pour yourself a little Diamante Añejo with a rock or neat, however you want to do it, and just relax and let the tequila do the rest.